And we are back with Shadow the Hedgehog.
I'm really depressed.
You should be. These levels are horrible.
I'm really upset, man. Because I kept holding off on watching this video with you, and I gained weight this week. The Sonic 06 diet. I need to watch it for it to work. I'm not going to slack off anymore.
Well, unfortunately, this is our last set of videos. We've just got to finish off Shadow. Lucky for you,
Oh boy, this level.
The levels have taken an average of 20 minutes, so we're gonna have a couple of updates to go through.
You were ranting about this everywhere.
Yeah. This level isn't as bad, but I have some things to complain about. But when we get to Kingdom Valley, you're probably not gonna be able to talk very much. I'm so angry. Also, there's fucking snowballs!
You
snowballs out of nowhere.
You underestimate the amount of time these levels take.
You underestimate the amount of things I have to say about them.
That's probably true. So back in this level for the 6th time, I think?
Yeah, I don't think it... Oh no, 7th, because it appears briefly in End of the World.
Completing this game means you have to do these levels over and over again. Alright. Okay.
This is what the people wanted.
This is what the people wanted.
The people being about, you know, 3 people, but whatever.
Watching
3 people
you...
requested it, and we're gonna do it.
Watching you play Sonic 06 has made me want to play Sonic again, though. And I saw there was a Humble Bundle for... And Generations you can get for, like, $4. And while I have it, it's like, man, I can get it on the PC. So I got it for $4. First level.
Well, I just can't wait till I am completely done with this, and I can just concentrate on Lost World, which I do really like, for the most part.
For the most part?
Yeah, there are some bad things about it. There's definitely some things that can be made fun of in that game. But, oh god, it's so much better than this, especially this DLC. This DLC is so bad! Look at all these stupid spikes!
Is that what the DLC is doing in this level? Because I think those spikes are there. Normally?
No, 100%? The spikes are not there normally.
Oh, okay.
I don't think there are normally any spikes hanging out. Especially just randomly in between enemies.
Probably. We've been watching these levels for so long.
Like, I can barely even remember when we first did this level. It was like 4 months ago.
Jesus, has it been that long?
I guess for this it was probably like 3.5, but we started this 4 months ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there's just nothing to say about this level anymore, or any of the levels really at this point.
There are some funny things to say about this that I'll probably be able to better show in video form. If you fuck with the giant snowball, it's kind of funny what happens. It'll just kind of pause. Like, if you let it hit you, it'll just sit there.
Really?
And then you start running, and then it restarts to chase you. And then you can let it hit you again. And this part doesn't work very well either because, well, I don't even know, but Shadow sometimes won't go through those stupid rings. It's annoying. This section at least isn't too bad because there's lots of invisible guys you can kill. And that'll beat it quicker. But
learn to play this game well at this point. Understand me.
I understand the shadow sections, which I didn't understand earlier. And I've kind of sort of mastered the chaos boost, which I was refusing to use earlier, just due to the fact that the chaos boost, it will kill you sometimes, and it can be very unpredictable, and I don't like unpredictability in a game that plays this poorly, but
yeah.
I'm using it to a little bit more effect now.
Okay. Oh, Rouge.
Yep.
Rouge. I mean, are we just calling her Rouge now?
Yeah, let's just call her Rouge.
That's the name she wants to go by.
Yeah, we don't want to just do anything silly about Rouge.
trying to glitch through.
Uh-huh.
I didn't know memory of this, if you showed it off earlier or not.
I did not show this glitch off earlier.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yeah, I figured... So, I have a funny story about this. There are also little caves like this on the left-hand side you can use to glitch further into the level.
Okay.
And you'll get back to Shadow. But the problem is, if you do that, you completely screw up the game and can't beat the level, because the game won't load the things you need to do to beat the level. And you will just wander around, wondering what the hell you're supposed to do. So you have to do this Omega section, because I just can't figure out any way you can beat the Shadow section without first beating the Omega section. And I can't figure out a way of getting to the beginning of the Shadow section that's at the end of this Omega section, so you just gotta go through the Omega section. Even though it can get really annoying, because his homing attack sometimes just doesn't work when there's only one enemy on the field, and his little uppercut won't work on robots.
I missed his little uppercuts.
I miss them too, and I'm kinda mad that sometimes they don't work. Like on these robots, it just doesn't work.
That's disappointing. Some points against Omega. He's really redeeming himself.
Yeah. By the end of this, maybe not by the end of this video, but by the end of Shadow's DLC, I think Omega will be disredeemed.
Aww. It's terrible.
He's bad.
He's a bad robot.
He's great against Iblis monsters, he's bad against robots. I guess he just can't betray his kind.
Possibly, yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, and here I'm basically realizing, fuck, the uppercuts aren't gonna work.
You're getting ready to enjoy yourself in this game, and it's just not gonna happen.
And yeah, the problem is sometimes you charge up your homing attack, and it just doesn't do anything. And you're like, god damn it, why isn't it doing anything?
And this is really slow.
So slow. So slow. But at least Omega sections aren't incredibly long. They're just sometimes very glitchy. And not glitchy in a fun way. But, at least...
Whoa.
For the most part, this level isn't too bad. Once you know that the glitch won't work a certain way, you're okay.
Once you know you can't break a level a certain way,
you're
fine.
A different way.
You're fine.
Yeah.
I'm surprised it didn't hurt you running into those lasers.
I'm kind
also, of... way position.
Camera. Yeah. There's a lot of camera problems in the DLC too. As they redesign these levels or repurpose them, they clearly did not put a lot of thought in, and the camera it's terrible.
So you've got your... car?
Yeah, we've got the buggy.
Buggy, okay.
Got the buggy.
Does this have an official name?
I think it's officially the buggy.
Oh, okay.
Which, you know, for Sonic 06, it's kind of perfect.
Yeah, I'd say so. Oh no, the lights on. Oh shit. Don't
check out that save!
Wow. Yeah, but it's a long. Oh, there's another car right. Excuse me, buggy right here.
Yeah. They're good about giving you extra buggies. They won't screw you over on a lack of buggies, but they'll screw you over in other ways. Oh god!
Take this camera.
Well, come on, I got some things to say about this level.
Do you?
I mean, their design philosophy is pretty incredible. But the way this level's broken... So, okay, see that grind rail on top of us?
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
What do you mean it doesn't work?
I first got here with Rouge, and I'm like, oh, cool, I'm gonna grind with Rouge, that's gonna be hilarious. And it doesn't work. I'm like, oh, that sucks.
Like, you just can't grind on it?
Yeah, you can't grind on it. So, I came back here with Shadow, and found that you still can't grind on it. And not only can't you grind on it, they have spikes on the grind rail.
Why?
I don't know. I think they intended you to grind on it, but they I don't know. I don't know what happened. But clearly they wanted you to grind on it.
And then they decided no.
And they wanted to make it challenging by adding spikes. Like, what the fuck?
Why would you ever go there? You're going this way, though.
Yeah, there's no reason to go on it. Other than you might be like, hey, it's fun to grind on things. I'm going to grind on them.
I'm going
to
explore.
I'm gonna have fun in this level. Oh, no, this spikes.
I thought this was the end right here.
No, and this is one of the things that's confusing. If you glitch in here, you go up here expecting there to be a ring. Or you go up here and you kill all these things. And what the hell? Why won't these things... Well, why won't it spawn? Why won't it spawn the end of the level? I want to win. But, hey, we're done. And that was pretty reasonable.
Oh, you have to kill... You have to knock over all the towers?
Yeah, so same as with regular level. Although it doesn't just automatically end. You do get a goal ring.
I will say that didn't feel like nearly 10 minutes, even though it was.
Yeah, there
I don't think you died at all, so...
There are stupid things...
worth an S rank in my mind.
There are stupid things about that level. I can rant about a lot of things in that level. I'll probably stick most of it in the bonus video so I can actually show it. But overall, for the DLC, for Shadow's DLC, not too bad. Now the next level. The next fucking level.
This is an S, come on. Oh, an A? Challenge. Why was that an S? That was perfect. Unacceptable.
It was pretty good. We killed a lot of stuff. And, well, actually, we did skip a section where there's a lot of things to kill, so I guess that's what...
That is true. Points.
Because that section we skipped is Rouge. They stick about a dozen stupid watchtowers in a tiny little area, and you've got to kill them, you've got to kill enemies. It's ridiculous. It's such shit. That's another thing that I could rant about in that level. But Kingdom Valley.
So I'm assuming that the rest of the video is just this level.
Just this level. Just this level. So strap in. I highly recommend watching this because you think you know Sonic 06. You think you know bad gameplay, bad game design, bad everything. No. This is the low point of this game to this point. There might be something worse later on. I'm not sure.
What? So that was very risky.
Well, the game forces you to do it. So you see those laser walls?
Yeah. Through the leaves, I was able to see the laser walls.
Okay. Now the glider can easily fit through the laser walls.
Okay.
And so the first time you play this, since you haven't had to kill enemies with the glider before, you just think, okay, I've just got to daredevil through the laser walls. No, you take damage that way.
Uh-oh.
See? That hurt us, even though we came nowhere close to the lasers.
Oh, I was looking at your rings, and I was like, wait, shouldn't you be dead? And then I realized, oh yeah, that held far.
So what you've got to do is you've got to kill the big robots. The big robots control the laser walls.
Okay.
Even though, so far, to this point in the game, you have not been required to kill the robots with the glider. You just have to avoid taking damage. So, the first time you play this, you're like, wait, what the hell? I just took damage. Did I accidentally hit it? And you might go through a second one and realize, no, you're still taking damage. And then you try and figure out, okay, are there things are there, like, control boxes? Are there switches? Oh no, it's these robots. And the auto-targeting really sucks for fighting the robots, so you kind of have to get around that. And...
How many times did you die there, initially?
Only once.
Only once, okay.
No, twice. Because twice. The second time I died, one robot hit me with about 6 missiles, and then it wouldn't target the robot at the end of the level, so I crashed into the final laser wall, and that killed me.
Fantastic. The loading screen seem a lot longer this time also. I don't know if that's just me.
I don't know about that, but... Rouge.
Okay, so... This section.
Usually we have to find 3 keys as Rouge. Okay. This time we get to find 6.
Man, I was thinking he's not gonna say 5. you can't say five, and you had to go one more.
He does what?
Well, that's just great.
It's wonderful. It's super. It's perfect. This game is the best. We love this game. It's a combat series.
So okay. Invisible dudes.
Yeah, the invisible dudes are the ones you want to target, although the auto-targeting is not perfect.
I can see that.
So at this point, I have gone through this section approximately 6 times.
Six by this point.
At least 6. Maybe 7. Maybe 8. I would say at least 6. So I know where everything is. I know how to beat everything for the most part. So I can do it almost optimally.
Question.
Yeah.
When you get a key, does it auto, I forget, does it auto, checkpoint when you get a key?
No.
Okay. So it's not like in the other games where you get, like, a Chaos Emerald piece, or, excuse me, a Master Emerald piece, and it immediately gives you a checkpoint.
No.
They okay. I'm expecting to watch that again.
But at least this part is once you know what you're doing, pretty easy, although this wall is amazing.
You get shot down, too.
The wall extends in midair, making it hard to get...
And you're going back up for some reason.
I want that one up!
We're just going back up.
Once you see the rest of this level, you'll know why I want that one up.
Probably. Oh, you got it. Good job.
I mean, it's not impossible to get, it's just poorly designed.
Whoa.
Watch out for more spike balls.
Spikes, what the hell?
Yep, can't move on until the enemies are gone.
Oh yeah, you're gonna bomb the window, or whatever.
Now, I haven't really talked about this a lot, but Rouge's wall climbing is incredibly poorly designed. It's really hard for her to get off of walls sometimes, and there are certain...
You can't just jump?
I'm trying to.
What?
There we go.
Like, I see that with Knuckles, too, but what's the problem there?
I don't know. And they haven't designed it so she can climb up every structure. And there are some very important structures that have flat walls that she can just not climb up, which leads to deaths. But once you know where the walls are that you can't climb, you die less because, well...
That's slow down.
Yeah.
I felt like they were slowed down in the loading screen earlier. Which is probably why I said... It seemed like it took so long. Doing pretty good.
Well, like I said, I've done this at least 6, possibly upwards of 10 times.
You just look like an expert. If you didn't tell... If you weren't voicing your frustrations all over the place, I would think you just got so good at this game.
Well, I mean, that's basically what happened. I mean,
You are so good at this game.
By playing this over and over and over, I've gotten really good at this section.
There's gotta be a checkpoint somewhere.
There's a checkpoint somewhere. But we've already gotten most of the keys, so spoiler, the checkpoint is after the keys. And I could really say a lot of things about this section. This is not a well-designed section, especially the way that the laser walls take a couple seconds to fall down or just deactivate after you, Oh, this fucking ambush is terrible. If you don't know what's coming, you're looking at the laser wall waiting for it to deactivate, and then there's just all these robots shooting you. And... They love their ambushes. They're horrible. But here we go. We've got almost all the keys.
Fantastic job.
I would ideally like to get lots of rings here so I can get another extra life in Shadow section, but I don't think that's going to happen. Especially because I think I'm going to get hit by one of these... Yeah. One of those robots.
I do like the mine on the wall. I think that's neat.
Do you like that it's heart-shaped?
Yeah, that totally fits her character.
You like that she puts her mind into a heart-shaped box?
Yes.
Me too.
Oh no, don't die. Oh god. No. No. I was just... Oh, Jesus. I was expecting just a missile to hit you after you killed it.
Oh, I thought you were saying that because of what I originally feared, that the robot had glitched out and that you were unable to attack it. Now, this is the first section of the level that filled me with ungodly rage. And then later it filled me with rage for a different reason, because I'd already mastered the thing that filled me with lots of rage. Those robots I just killed, once they signaled the other robots to come in, they will fly up into the air, and your bullets may just miss them, but I'll get back to that in a second, because this next part is the fucking stupidest. You have to kill this guy in midair, and then after you kill him in midair, you have to turn and blindly do a homing attack onto that platform. And when you're first...
So you're supposed to abandon that first thing.
Yeah. It's designed for you to abandon it. I don't think there's any way to kill that robot in midair. So you have to blindly homing attack, get back on that platform, which you will die at the first few times because it's fucking difficult. And then...
What?
Then there's the problem of the robots that will fly up into the air if you've missed them. So you'll be attacking them, you'll be firing bullets at them, for some reason the bullets aren't hitting them, and then they'll fly up in the air, and the robots they've signaled then hit you with all their bullets and you die. And you're so angry. You're so angry at this point. Because you just mastered the stupid blind homing attack onto a platform, and now you're screwing up the stupid robots flying that you thought weren't a problem, and you're just full of rage. And then there are more things, but I think we'll encounter them a little later, so...
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I was thinking that something was going to fall again, but I was like, oh my god!
The wonderful thing about that first one is you can't see it. There's one of those fallen towers in front of you that doesn't have a tower on it. So you think, okay, there's no towers to worry about here. Then one that's just hidden in the background falls on you. And you're like, what the fuck? And even though it's late at night and you don't want to be a screaming lunatic who people driving by in their cars can hear as you scream about Sonic 06, you just scream, what the fuck?
Ultra careful right here, I can see.
Yes. This is a cover shooter. Didn't you know that, Hulkamat? I shouldn't make that joke now because there's a section in Flame Core where you're playing as Omega where I legitimately treated this as a cover shooter.
No!
What? Okay. I said what three times, by the way. I accidentally had my mic muted. But what? What the hell was that?
That was some good game design, Hulkamat.
What just happened? How did that happen?
Don't ask me.
There were no lasers.
The lasers, they cycled back in. The lasers, they're on a
load of shit.
It's a load of shit.
That's just... You were doing so well. I was like, oh my god, this level's just probably ultra long and he's gonna get through it all in one go, the way he's going.
Oh no. You haven't seen half the bullshit in this level!
That's absurd.
Especially if you haven't seen the bonus video. Because since you couldn't record for a couple of days, I just had rage inside of me that I had to let out, and I posted a bonus video where I yelled about this a little bit. So I'm just so mad. I can't believe I did this.
I can't believe you died. After, like, such a flawless run, also.
Yeah.
The dream is dead.
I got those sombreros.
So, yeah, I was thinking those looked like sombreros.
Either that or, like, really stereotypical samurai hats.
Okay, so this thing has a tower.
Yeah. Now, there's another way we can get around. I saw a Darkspine Sonic video where he did it, and I'm like, you know what? Let's avoid that stupid bullshit section.
I can't believe you didn't get hit by a ball there. Hey, an extra life.
Yeah, we got an extra life. The other thing is I died, so I'm like, I'll get the extra life. So even if I lose it, this will be this will be an even transaction.
Yeah. There's one of them up there. You can shoot it.
You can shoot him. And if you're good enough, you can fly onto that platform.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. Now, if you take that hovercraft that's on top of there and just jump down into the water, it will also explode. So I don't think there's a safe way, unless you get onto the tower, of getting back down.
Wait, so if you were just to drive all the way down to the bottom and land in the water, you'd explode?
No, if you jump off the top. If you try to drive down to the bottom, I think you'll get hit by those spawning spikes.
Oh.
So I don't think I would want to do that. That and those stairs are so finicky, I think you'll just flip over and die. Either way, we're not going to be going up there to experiment with it. So...
Yeah, I could, yeah, doing that once I can see. But...
Yeah. Granted,
if you're trying to become a speedrunner, I can see it.
Well, not just a speedrunner, you avoid that whole tunnel section. And that tunnel section, that'll kill you. Especially if you don't have a lot of confidence. And at this point, Hulkamat, I don't have a lot of confidence. This game is just sapped my will. If I were not doing this Let's Play, I would never be doing this.
You turn it.
I would have quit. I almost quit. Like, I seriously was about to say, you know what, I quit. Maybe I'll come back to this in 3 months. I'm going to play Sonic Lost World.
You made it, though. You've made it this far. Might as well go through with it. What happened there?
I don't know.
What a piece of shit.
Let's get going.
Okay. So, how are you feeling at this point?
Okay, this is the exact sound I made when that happened.
You're all angry, you want to get through this quickly, and then you almost die right there. It's like, okay... I guess I'll play carefully.
I don't even know what I want to do at this point.
That guy was way high up.
Yeah, like once they've spawned in their buddies, they fly up, and killing them when they're high up is a risk when you've got to try to land on a platform that you can't see. But let's go back and do this. Let's go back and.
I think you'll do this.
I don't even know. I honestly don't know. I can assure you that unless it was a fever dream, I did beat this level and I recorded it. I'm pretty sure that I uploaded the correct recording of me beating this level. So I have over an hour of footage of me playing this and failing. Of just this level. I hate this level so much.
Oh boy.
Here we go. I think I've said all the horrible things I can say about this particular part. This part is terrible, but I think we've explored all of the reasons it sucks. Now, once we get past that laser gate that we died at the first time, we can then explore the reasons why the next part sucks.
We're gonna make it.
I think we make it this time.
Alright. We're gonna make it, everybody.
I think I get some confidence and realize, you know what, I can just go right by these robots. They won't turn around and hit me, I can just go right by them. And then I'll just carve up these.
You only have a limited time to get through it? What's the deal here?
Well, see, it's gonna cycle. It's gonna cycle in and out, but we did it. And look!
Checkpoint!
And now we get... to...
I saw that your little boat thing was nearly, going to explode, and then you got out of it and didn't.
I need to talk here. I need to say something about this. Okay. So, when you get to this point, you fight these enemies, and you figure that this laser wall will go down when they die. But they don't. And then you see an eagle off in the distance, and you think, oh, I've got a homing attack to that eagle. But you can't. So you try it again, and it doesn't work. And I really wish I had just taken some time here so you would just understand why that part is so bad. So then you realize that you can chaos boost, and you chaos boost. And then you try and chaos boost to the eagle, which doesn't work. And eventually you realize that they want you to chaos boost through... The eagle is also kind of glitched.
I see that.
Then you realize they want you to chaos boost through there, but sometimes it doesn't work. So you have to get through it another way, which is just continually spin attacking. If you spin attack in the corner, you'll eventually get through too. But luckily, on the first try, I managed to just chaos boost through. And I don't think the chaos boost has ever been used in that way, where you have to get through a laser.
No.
So you don't really think of it.
I didn't even know you could do that. But then again, I don't know a lot of things that I see. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You show me a lot of things, and then I forget it by the next video.
Yeah. Oh, and when you're killing the robots, they start respawning, so that eventually, even if you waste your chaos boost, you'll have enough power to get it back. But they respawn, like, one at a time, so it's not in the same pattern that you see the first time. So you're kind of like, oh, okay, I just have to kill another wave of enemies. And then they respawn again, and eventually you realize, oh, these are the same robots. They're just, you know, spawning, you know, one at a time. Okay, I need the chaos boost. I need the chaos boost to that eagle. And again, you'll try it a couple of times. And because, you know, it takes a little bit of time to get the chaos boost back, you're wasting time. And you're dying, and maybe you ran out of lives there, and you've got to replay the whole level. So, that's just a mess. It's horrible. And then we've got this section.
Okay.
I'm gonna let it speak for itself.
Oh boy.
Without doing a certain exploit, I'm not gonna call it a glitch, it's an exploit, I could not bridge that gap. I've seen other people do it easily, so I don't know if it's like a 360 to PS3 thing, I don't know what it is, but I've tried like waiting, I've tried pushing forward, I've tried doing it soon, I've tried going to the side. I cannot get him to homing attack that fucking next enemy. But luckily there is a way around it. So I'm going to do that in this attempt. So we're not going to waste that much time. But I lost several lives trying to figure out like different ways I could get that fucking thing to work. And I had a game over at this point too, which... is the worst, because
Stressful. It
was the first time I'd... So here we go.
Chaos spinning?
Yeah. And someone did ask if there were any more upgrades for Shadow. There was one more, so that's the final chaos spit upgrade.
Okay.
But yeah, you can chaos spit infinitely into the air, and it will slowly move you forward. Which I used in that case to fucking do that. All this stupid fucking bullshit to have to do.
And we're... with Mr. Uppercut here.
Yeah, and
that was really pitiful.
Yeah. Like, just randomly, his homing attack won't want to work. And you'll just be like, what the hell is going on? And, you know, sometimes doesn't homing attack the guy right in front of you who you wanted to homing attack. But, you know, in this particular level, Omega is a minor nuisance. Compared to all the other characters... Actually, no, Rouge isn't too bad. And compared to Shadow, who is a... He is the ultimate life form of nuisances.
Huh?
He's the ultimate nuisance. And this section sucks. This section sucks. Because until you...
You're here.
You have to kill the enemies. But until you kind of realize you have to position the camera to get them, you know, it'll take you a little while. And then they're telling you, oh, you have to go down here. And when you get down here, there's more enemies to kill, but it's not obvious where they are. So by the time you turn around,
because
the camera doesn't let you see them. Like, I still don't know exactly where they are.
Yeah.
I have...
I like when he gets hit and his body just completely disappears.
But now we go up this way.
That's another reason Gamma is superior to Omega, because when he attack, you just keep attacking people over and over again. You don't have to wait for each shot.
Yeah, Omega is so much better.
What? No, he's not.
I mean, Gamma is so much better.
Like, oh god, what did I say?
Yeah, that, I'm sorry, Gamma. You are the superior robot. I have said this repeatedly. To the point where I don't even like this inferior robot, and it took me a long time to warm up to him, and I immediately cooled on him, so trust me, Gamma. I love you, and not this one.
Gamma.
And in a frightening section, I was down to one ring, and then I realized that we're coming up on that section that I died on a lot when I played through this normally. But luckily, now that I've dealt with all the bullshit that is inherent in this level, that section that I died on doesn't seem so bad. And I'm not gonna have any problems with it. Oh god. Yeah, joy. Let's kill these enemies. But, I mean, for the most part, the worst of this level is over. We can kind of calm down. There's some dumb stuff yet to come, but for the most part, it's reasonable. This nothing is too bad compared to what we've seen. But, I mean, of what you've seen so far, this is of the worst video game, gameplay, level design, everything you've ever seen, right?
Yeah.
But there's that.
Wasn't that the original platform where you just completely veer off?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I'm shocked you did that on one try. I was just waiting for it to happen. I thought you were setting it up, too.
No. Well, once you know to anticipate that, it's not too bad. So,
what is this? Wait. Hold on. No. No. Really? That's annoying.
It's not as bad as it seems.
I guess, but it's like
we are actually making progress in the level. We don't have to repeat that section.
Okay.
When I first saw this, I was like, "You motherfucker! I'm gonna have to repeat."
Maze.
But either we solve the maze the correct way, or each section just leads you to a new path that takes you to the end. I don't know. I don't care. I'm never playing this again. I don't give a shit what is at the end of the maze. So, the enemies spawn in after, and they ambush you.
Oh boy, this is scary.
Yeah, it's really scary. It's really scary, really easy to die on. So I'm trying to find out if like I can just chaos spin them here, because this will kill certain enemies. But,
man, you can't spit in that direction.
Yeah.
I see. Oh, and you need to kill them, too.
You need to kill them.
We're at the finishing stretch. I recognize this portion. I also remember a point where I got really nervous.
It looked a little different this time.
Yeah.
But
they're also killing these enemies.
Yeah.
Oh, this isn't the end!
It's almost the end, though, so don't worry. Although, we need to get those rings.
Yeah.
It's funny how many extra lives they give you. We have 5 now.
Does chaos boosting make you, like, invincible for a time?
Certain things don't hit you.
Yeah, because I thought you got shot a few times.
And the laser walls won't hurt you for the most part. I swear I've been hurt by them once or twice, but it's over.
Yes. And Omega was just standing there. Great job. 17 minutes, 17 seconds.
17, we're done. We'll be back soon with Crisis City and Flame Core.
Oh, joy. Let's see. What the hell do they expect?
I don't know. I don't fucking know.